بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم طلبة المرحلة الخامسة كلية الطب جامعة ميسان. We started a series lectures in oral and maxillofacial surgery. We started our lecture today about the fracture of the mandible. The fracture generally is defined as a breakage or discontinuity of the bone integrity. The surgical anatomy of the mandible. The mandible represents the lower third of the face. It's composed from the body of the mandible, ramus, angle of the mandible, and superiorly two processes, anteriorly the coronoid process and posteriorly the condyle. The mandible has a thick lower border in the interior region, so it's more stronger than the posterior area, especially the neck of the condyle, which is considered the most weak point in the structure of the mandible. The mandible is more commonly fractured than the other bones of the face because it's a prominent and exposed situation. And bellows to the mandible are transmitted to the base of the skull through the temporomandibular joint. In the mandible, there are many lines of the weakness, such as the presence of the long canine tooth, considered as a weak point. And when we have a partial erupted wisdom or completely unerupted teeth, and in case of the alveolar resorption in the patient with the edentulous, that means the patient lost his teeth completely. This x-ray showed mixed dentition of the patient, unerupted permanent teeth here, and this is the deciduous tooth. This follicle of the tooth considered as a weak point, that means the patient may be with the minimum trauma exposed to the fracture of the mandible. And the another X in this X-ray here, completely edentulous patient, and usually patient when he lost his teeth, there is resorption and weakness in the structure of the mandible. Here the pointer showed the impacted tooth also considered as a weak point. The fracture of the mandible classified face according to the nature of the injury, civilian type of the fracture, a fracture with no cross comminution and no extensive loss of the hard and soft tissue, which is mostly occur in the fighting and road traffic accident. A gunshot fracture, fracture with the cross comminution, and there is extensive destruction of the both hard and soft tissue, which most occur due to muscle injury. A fracture also classified according to the type. Simple fracture, a breakage of the bone with the little damage to the surrounding tissue, and there is no tear in the overlying mucosa and the skin. So it's considered as a closed fracture. And there is no communication to the exterior and interior surface. Compound fracture, one or more line of the fracture with the tear to overlying skin and or mucosa. So there is wound exposed to the outer surface, and such as in dentoalveolar fracture, the fracture is more potentially exposed to the infection. Comminuted fracture is characterized by shattering of the bone to the multiple small fragments. Pathological fracture occur when the patient have generalized skeletal disease or localized skeletal disease. Generalized skeletal disease such as hyperparathyroidism. That means increased hyperparathyroid hormone stimulated the osteoclast to liberate the calcium from the bone to the bloodstream. So the patient with the hyperparathyroidism, usually with the increased porosity of the bone. The other generalized skeletal disease such as osteogenesis imperfecta, osteitis deformans, and fibrous dysplasia. Localized skeletal disease such as osteomyelitis, odontogenic cyst, benign and malignant neoplasm. A green stick usually occur in children below the 12 years. There is more elasticity of the bone. usually can see this green stick fracture in the condyle neck of the mandible. The most commonly used classification of the mandibular fracture usually according to the site. So, say dento-alveolar fracture when the fracture in the alveolar bone of the teeth, condylar fracture, coronoid fracture, ramus, angle, body symphysis in the midline between the two central and parasymphysial in the canine region. The subcondylar fracture, the neck, is most commonly cited for the fracture, represent 36%, the angle of the mandible 20% and 21%. In the body of the mandible. The coronoid process is less common fracture of the mandible. Now the clinical examination started with the general examination of the patient. The patient must be carefully examined and palpated because the patient may be have also cerebral hemorrhage or a fracture the vertebrae or other bones or intra-abdominal hemorrhage. So the failure to diagnose any of these injuries might result in surgical disaster. In addition to the medical history should be taken. The local examination of the mandibular, usually done by the use of a clean with the white gauze to remove any blood clot for accurate evaluation of the soft tissue laceration, bleeding source, if there is any foreign body, any fragment of the filling, any fragment or fracture of the denture if the patient wear denture. The local examination of the mandible consists from extra oral examination, usually by inspection and palpation. Inspection to see if there is any ecchymosis, swelling, soft tissue laceration, obvious deformity of the bone contour, palpation by use the tip of the finger to palpate it, the condylar region, the lower border of the body of the mandible to the symphysial region. So, intraoral examination, also inspection to the buccal sulcus, inspected for any hematoma, ecchymosis. The ecchymosis in the buccal sulcus is not necessarily indicative of the mandibular fracture, while the lingual side is pathognomonic of the mandibular fracture. When we see ecchymosis in the floor of the mandible, that means more than 95% there is a fracture of the mandible. Also inspected if there is a false tooth, that means the tooth removed from its location, missing tooth, fracture filling, check the inner surface of the lip, cheek also. Palpation, palpated the buccal and lingual sulcus for any tenderness, step deformity, any swelling, any mobility of the teeth. The most common sign and symptom of the mandibular fracture are the damage of the teeth, a swelling tenderness over the TM joint, deviation of the occlusion also indicated the bone fracture. Open bite when we have a bilateral condylar fracture. Also, we can we see swelling, bleeding, ecchymosis, and tenderness. On the palpation extra and intra orally. Now, after the clinical examination, if the condition of the patient permit, so we do radiographical examination. It's either intra oral radiographs or extra oral radiographs. The intra oral radiography, periapical and occlusal film we can use. In extraoral radiography, we can send the patient for oblique lateral of the mandible, evaluated. The oblique lateral view can be evaluated the lines of the body, angle, condylar neck fracture. PA of the mandible, most commonly used and the main x-ray for the fracture of the mandible, orthobantography, OBG. We can evaluate the mandible from the right to the left side, evaluate the body, the condyle region, and also we can evaluate the dentition. This is the OBG. Here we can see the condyle, the neck of the condyle, the coronoid, the ramus, the angle. Here the X-ray showed the fracture body of the mandible, the parasymphysial and symphysial region, partially erupted tooth. So the OBG consider the main X-ray of the mandibular fracture. Also, this OBG show detachment lower border of the mandible fracture. Arch bar used for the fixation and immobilization of the mandibular movement. This is the X-ray OBG showed the parasymphysial fracture in the canine region. This X-ray showed fracture the angle of the mandible. Fracture angle of the mandible with the present partial erupted tooth. So we must decide whether this tooth is indicated for extraction or not. Sometimes this tooth considered as a pathway for the oral infection of the fracture line. So when the infection occurred, delay of the union happened. So in most of the cases, the tooth is removed and suturing the area before we do the reduction, fixation, and immobilization of the mandible. This is periapical X-ray show longitudinal fracture of the root of the tooth. So if the fracture happened in this side, the fracture line may be exposed to the infection from the adjacent area. So the periapical X-ray give more detail about the tooth and surrounding tissue, periodontal ligament, and surrounding condition of the patient, if, of the tooth, if associated with the periapical infection or carious tooth, considered as a source of the infection to the fracture line. The other X-ray used for the evaluated the mandible reverse down view for the condylar neck, temporomandibular joint, transcranial, transpharyngeal, and arthrography, CT scan, and MRI. Now we reach the definitive treatment. The step of the treatment, the fracture of the mandible started with the reduction, then fixation and immobilization, then follow up and rehabilitation. Reduction is either closed reduction done by manual manipulation. This type of the reduction, no need for the general anesthesia, usually in most cases done by local anesthesia. Open reduction done by under the general anesthesia, surgical exposed both and surgically, and then do reduction. Open reduction is more precise, but the complication associated with this type of the reduction is the use of the general anesthesia. Now the fixation and immobilization. After we do the reduction, the securing of the proper reduction done by fixation. The period of the fixation different or vary according to the site of the fracture. That means the fracture of the symphysial region different in the period from the fracture the condylar neck. Also, the period of the fixation affected by the presence of the retained root is either with the periapical lesion or heavily carious tooth. The age of the patient, over the 40 years, different from the patient with the 15 years. The presence or the absence of the infection also may cause delay the union of the both side of the fracture. Generally, for the period of the fixation for the healthy young patient, about 3 weeks. We can add 1 week if there is tooth in fracture line. We can add 1 week if the age of the patient above the 40 years. We can add 1 week another if there is infection or exposed the fracture line. And we can subtract 1 week if the age of the patient below the 12 years. That means the period of the fixation is in generally extended between 3 weeks to the 6 weeks. The method of the fixation, we can use the dental or the teeth dental wiring or use the teeth for the fixation by direct wiring, interdental eyelet wiring. We can use the arch bar or use the bone for the fixation by transosseous wiring, upper border wiring, lower border wiring, extraoral pin fixation, bone plating, or trans fixation with the Kirchner or K wires. This X picture, sorry, showed direct wiring. This is the fracture line, and we can use the dentition for the fixation by direct wiring, one tooth from each side. This is the arch bar used for the fixation of the fracture mandible, and we can use also for immobilization by do wiring between the upper and lower arch bar. Intraosseous wiring, we can make hole in each side of the fracture and make direct wiring or figure 8 wiring of both sides. Most commonly nowadays use the bone plating, bone plate made from nickel titanium, and do screwing in each side, and the arch bar used to do the immobilization. In addition to the hard fixation, we can sometimes use the immobilization of the movement of the mandible. And this is the plating, bone plate and arch bar used to do the immobilization. The complication of the mandibular fracture, anesthesia, paresthesia, because the mandible contained an inferior border, the inferior dental canal or inferior alveolar canal, in which the inferior alveolar nerve passed through it. The other complication is skin scar, the arrangement of the occlusion, ankylosis due to hematoma in the capsule of temporomandibular joint, malunion, delay union, non-union, also deformity of the mandible, biogenic infection, gingivitis, actinomycosis considered as a complication of mandibular infection, traumatic myositis ossificans of the masseter muscle, also a rare complication of the mandibular fracture. Malunion consider is malposition. Yeah, that means the union happened but in malposition. Delay union, when the joint or united both sides of the fracture occur more period, longer than ordinary period. Non-union mean there is no united or joint both sides of the fracture. Radiographs show rounded off and sclerosing of bone ends revealed the condition referred as named eprination. Eprination, that means both end cannot join, and is a treatment by do refreshment wound. That means the reduction, repeated the reduction and fixation and immobilization of the mandible. Also, we have another condition, fibrous union, when the both fracture end joined by fibrous tissue, not osseous tissue. So in this condition can be treated by remove the fibrous tissue and repeated the reduction and fixation and immobilization of the mandible. And finally, thank you very much.